Wondering if you have access to the new LinkedIn Premium Company Pages? Let me walk you through and show you where you can find it if you do have access to this feature. So I'm going to start on the public view of my company page. And if you're an admin of your page probably looks a little bit different when you go to it. So I'm going to click now on View as Admin to go into the backend view. Now you will need to have admin access to see if you have this feature available to you. What you'll need to do is look in the left-hand column, scroll down, and if you do have the option to upgrade to premium pages, you should see the little gold square followed by the text Try Premium Page. Now, I haven't seen a real compelling reason to upgrade yet. LinkedIn does give you a free 1 month trial, but after that, you can see here it's currently $69.99 per month. And I've even heard some people being charged $99 per month. So I always look at what's the ROI that you get out of that. And as someone who specializes in LinkedIn, who's a heavy user of the platform and also heavily focused on growing my company page because I believe it's a great lead generating source for my business, here are the things that I've seen on here that I think could be of value for you as it relates to deciding whether or not to upgrade. Okay, I'm going to highlight from their checklist the things that I think would be worth that monthly investment. First of all, see who's visited your page. Now, this is something we can't currently see the visitors, but we can see some high-level analytics in terms of demographics and things like that. So, seeing who's visited is very similar to the see who's visited your profile. People might be looking at your profile because something caught their attention, but they either didn't think to invite you to connect yet or they're not ready to. Now, this similar to pages, if they're visiting your page, there might be a reason. So that right there could be an opportunity to discover new potential leads, and I would call them lukewarm at this point, right? Moving down, there's some other things that I think could be interesting. I don't know if I would pay for them necessarily, but building trust by displaying a client testimonial at the top of your page. So, by paying for premium, LinkedIn is enabling some additional features, including being able to highlight a client testimonial. If I can find a page that's using it, I'll drop it in the YouTube comments so you can see an example of this. Again, not sure if it's worth paying for, but might be interesting on here. There's some other things on here that would possibly appeal to me, one of which is growing your followers faster by auto-inviting prospects to your page. Now, my understanding is if people are visiting your page, it's sending out the auto invitation. I'm going to verify that that is the case. I think they're using this term prospects maybe a little bit liberally here because how do we know if they're prospects or not? So I'll look into that more, but I think the auto-invite feature is definitely something that's appealing to me. So I'll look in to see what that is, but this could certainly grow your page faster. And if people are invited to follow your page and they clicked on accept, then it could turn them from a lukewarm into a potential warm lead for you. So I think that is of interest. Now, they also give you a one-time $500 LinkedIn ads credit, one per paid subscription. Now, you can easily say, well, Brenda, if I upgrade, I get my $500 ad credit and basically 5 months of the page are paid for. Generally speaking, LinkedIn ads are a lot more expensive. They are definitely a source of finding people who are in the B2B world, but generally speaking, if you're going to be spending money on LinkedIn ads, it's not similar to Facebook or Instagram. You can't just spend $500 and expect to get some lift from it. If you're spending money on LinkedIn ads, you should be spending in the neighborhood of 3,000 to 5,000 plus per month on a regular basis, and maybe even going for 3 months, 6 months, even for a year before you start seeing some return on that. And your product price point should be a bit higher. I remember back in the day, our product price point was 20 to 25,000 for my organization. It made sense. Lower ticket price items just doesn't make sense to spend money on LinkedIn ads. It's better to optimize your profile, engage your team, and use maybe some of the other premium solutions versus LinkedIn ads. Now, I have seen ads work for organizations, but usually larger enterprise organizations. So that's what I see in terms of benefits for the LinkedIn Premium Company page. If you do have any additional questions, feel free to reach out to me. And if you found this video helpful, I'd love to hear it in comments. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.